By hearing and hearing by the word of God. If you don't talk to them, you don't let them share. You see, just note, if you listen to the radio or television with any bad or deadly news, if you are not careful, that pollutes your mind. Anything that you are told will have an impact in your life, your behavior, your attitude. It will. Whether good or bad, if anything of joy, you are in fairness, people will see you and say, ah, what is happening? I don't hope you have won the lotto. No. Nobody would win it here anymore in the name of Jesus. Ah, people are not saying amen. Whether you say amen, I'm making a decree. Right, I know many of you are the customers of lotto. I'm giving another way by the special grace of God that anyone, I'm standing on the altar of fire, that we want to waste money and go and play lotto, you will lose in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you think that is the cheapest and the quickest way of making money, it is not. You will enter into the garment of lotto. When you start to sell your properties, am I lying?
No.
God, are you hearing me?
No, sir.
Aha. I'm not saying he's playing lotto. I know those who are playing lotto here. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Most of us often walk into the prison yard of Satan by our actions or inactions. Things we are supposed to do, or things we are supposed to do, you are not doing it. Since that you are supposed not to do, you are to doing it. That is the actions and inactions. By the group of people we associate with, this influences our behavior. And also by our attitude. By our attitude. I'm unbundantly, you know, I've just written the pastor's desk, robbers of miracles. I've just written it now. As God laid it in my hand, robbers of miracles. And I'm relating to that here. That also, apart from your attitude and your behavior, is also by the robbers that plunder your miracles and blessings. Which are those robbers? The robbers are paid mainly to anger and pride. Anger and pride. Those are the robbers of miracles. And if you are not careful, those things can really deflate you completely. God had in the heart of King Pharaoh to make his word, because he said, I will showcase this man, because it was because of this that Pharaoh was created in the first instance. So that the whole world will glorify me that I am tough. Even though God is a lamb, he's also a lion. He's a consuming fire. So God made his heart to be hardened. Can you imagine? He went out with 600 of the chariots to pursue the Israelites. But was it not the same person who said, go and pray for me? And he said, I hope he woke up the following morning and said, ah, what nonsense have I done? God will confuse your enemies.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
See, anybody who will want to, there is a Yoruba saying that whoever will have a slap at night, if he sleeps at 12 o'clock, he will wake up, at 13 o'clock. Because he must go there to be slapped. When something, if you see it,